Sorry, okay. Hi, my name is Mikendell, and today I will be performing the Chant, Nuptual by Lucom. Register shifts. I feel like going in between those, I struggle, and up towards the top, I'm like reaching for it and air support when I do those register shifts.
Okay. Students?
Yeah?
Hi!
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Yeah.
I love your performance. I don't get to
least that's the only reason I know. Like, he's always like, why do you feel like it needs to be small? Why are you doing that? And I'm like, I don't know. But I think if maybe you just tried unlocking that jaw and brow a little bit, it would get a little more sound and you'd be more happy with the way that it's coming right up and out. So, but really great job. I love the performance tonight.
Yeah, there's a lot of sound coming out now. I noticed you took these amazing breaths, but it was like two words and they were gone. So is that like airflow or, cause you have asthma, don't you?
I do have asthma.
Asthma? You got glaucoma?
No, that's legit. Like she has asthma, and that's something that those of you who are gonna teach, you don't have students that have asthma or COPD or something like that. And it's definitely something that's a struggle.
Yeah, cause the breaths were huge.
Yeah, Dr. Griffith, Dr. Chris Griffith, on a steel, who had asthma.
But I could see that you were supporting, and it was a good breath. Yeah.
Great job.
Thank you.
Touching.
Yes.
It was so good. What I was wondering is if, because I did see but I wondered if you were locking your upper abs, because I could see that you had support lower, but I wondered if there was a locking.
I
think
you
took a nice breath, but I wondered if it was really going
in
where you were letting the air.
I think it gets lost. I don't know where it goes.
And then also it always
disappears.
Yeah. Or maybe you're farting on stage. Kind of good out and then kind of back up. And I didn't know if that was something that there. But I would watch those two things because those were huge for me too. Yeah. Keeping that posture. Yes. Not pull back too far because I started doing that and that caused problems.
Yeah. different problems.
Yeah. It's kind of like the basketball thing, but yeah. I was trying to, and it's something that Dr. R told me recently about thinking of this worked for me. A piece of dental floss from like down here where you have your support to like your tailbone and just thinking of that support drawing every time you take a breath. And that helps me really focus on the support and not coming left or anywhere.
Hello.
I got asthma too, so I know like what's going on like, because it's like the register shifts, right?
Yeah.
Like they're really hard to like catch like, your breath in between them. Mm-hmm. But I think you get it real good, like you get a low nose, they're real clear, and they sound really nice.
Thank you.
So, I loved your performance, it was so lovely. But one thing, during your performance, I was so distracted because your hands were just like right here. And I tried.
I was like, oh crap.
Yeah, that was like the one thing that like, I was like, it's so pretty, but then I was like, what are your hands doing? Like I was like a little confused, I was like, but like, I really liked it.
Don't.
Like, I know that like, I'll either like get stuck and like, hands at your side, but then I'm like, wait. Oh, I was doing my hands. So, like, maybe practice in front of a mirror. I know that helps, even though I hate looking at myself when I'm singing. It's awful. It's gross. But I really loved your performance, other than, like, I just kept getting, like, fired for
hands. I had to do it to him.
No, but, like, it was a lovely performance, and I love how clear your tone has gotten. Like, your tone has gotten so much clearer since I've heard you sing versus last semester and this semester and, like, your opera. So I love hearing your voice progress. It's so exciting. Okay. That was great.
Dr. Griffith. For me, I think it's the voice is the sound is still too far back. Mm-hmm. So I would recommend you could take this piece and be a great piece for it and hum it. Mm-hmm. I think it's going to put it right in the front where you want it. And so I think it's kind of too strong for you. You feel it's too far back, and something in you back there can't flow. And so then we get something that sounds kind of splayed and airy. But I think if you hum, I think we'll have a more slimmer focused exhale, and it will also be more fun. And I think it will be a very quick way for you to change that.
Giving yourself more time to breathe might set you up.